We do take this very seriously and have done for some time in terms of how we work to support students in Selly Oak and their fear of crime in Selly Oak. The additional police that have been referenced that have been there for 3 weeks prior to the account of the incident, rather, they came from a discussion between the university and the police, looking at, well, what could we do to recognise there's a spike every year, every university town, pretty much, when students return or freshers arrive, there's a spike in crime in student areas. And we said, well, what can we do about that? Is there something we can do? And the police said, yeah, we can. We can look at additional police officers, and they put those on the street and responded to the discussions between the guild, between the police and the university. In November this year, there'll be five additional police officers coming to Selly Oak. They're called Blue Line Specials. Now, that takes well over a year to organise, but it will be five officers patrolling the area. Now, the university's worked on that for well over a year because we recognise there's some real concerns and we want to do what we can to allay those fears and to help drive down where there may be particular instances of crime, and burglaries are particularly serious in terms of numbers in Selly Oak, how we can help drive those down. And we can do that by increasing police presence, and the university's paying to cover some of the costs of that working with the police. We also had a conversation actually this week with the police about some additional staffing and what might be able to do there. Could we go further than those five additional police? And that's what we're now looking at as well. So this is something that the university is looking at both now, but has also been looking at for some time and working on for some time. As I say, it takes time to train a police officer. That means there's always a lead time, and they're coming in November. But we have a number of other initiatives that we've been working on for some time, whether they be things that, you've heard the reference to the Bournebrook Pavilion, deliberate intention to create a community space where we can bring different members of the community together on the edge of the university campus and on the edge of Selly Oak. Absolutely deliberate intention to say, where can we create somewhere that we can bring different parts of the community and work together on what the issues are? Because when we look at the causes and the challenges around crime, a lot of the solutions to those are things where the university can help. The university can be a catalyst to bring different parties together, and we can do that working with the council, we can do that working with the MP, we can do that working with the businesses, because we have a level of engagement. And that's something I think that we're particularly focused on now, and part of the basis of bringing Bournebrook into play and having that space and having a new community role in there was so we can do that. So there's a brand new role that's there, so we can put that in place. Now, that's not in response to this incident, that's in response to the concern that's been raised by students over the past couple of years. So we've responded to that at that point, and we continue to do so. There's a genuine fear about crime, and I absolutely understand it. If this had happened on my street, I'd be reacting exactly the same way. I want to know, what on earth is going on? How can this happen? How can we as a community be assaulted in this way? And I absolutely understand it. And I'm here to listen, to understand your perspective on how we can work together more effectively to really address your concerns, but also support the community as a whole in Selly Oak. Much of the population in Selly Oak will not be students. So how do we work and bring them in to this issue as well? How do we work as a single group of people to make the environment much better? There are staff who live in Selly Oak that you heard referenced, whether it be police or university staff. There are alumni who live in and around Selly Oak, as well as students who live in Selly Oak. It's a broader community, and what can we do to bring that community together most effectively? And that's where we're particularly focusing our attention, in addition to these extra resources that come in very, very soon.